Hello everyone, welcome to the Crown of the Iron King DLC. The last time I played was about a month ago with the last piece of DLC, so I'm probably going to be a bit rusty, but hopefully my skills haven't gotten too bad in the meantime. I've also taken the liberty of stashing away most of the items that I got during the last DLC, so that hopefully it'll be pretty clear what I pick up that's new, because I really want to check out all the new items and, you know, read the descriptions and whatnot, so I don't have too much in my inventory as far as equipment goes. Of course, my item list is still a wasteland of bottomless abyss of... I don't even know. Anything that goes into there is... it's not going to come back out. I'm never going to find it, ever. But anything that goes into weapons and armor and whatnot should be pretty easy to find. Of course, though, I kept my beautiful crown from the Crown of the Sunken King. Ooh, I forgot to put away my leggings. My ironclad leggings! Oh well, they can stay. It's fine. So yeah, put all that stuff away. A couple of things I did, I upgraded my... one of my pieces of armor I upgraded once, which I believe puts all of my armor to the max quality they can possibly be. Plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, plus 5, yeah, okay. I think it was the gloves. So yeah, now every single piece of armor I have is completely maxed out. Along with my weapon, of course. My weapon's been maxed out at plus 10 for a very long time. And I also replaced one of my rings. Instead of using the ring of life, is it called? Yeah, instead of using the life ring plus one, I think I'm just going to use the bracing knuckle ring. Whoops, I didn't mean to get rid of it. I meant to look at the description. Yeah, it's the one that slows equipment degradation, because I've had some serious problems with my equipment just breaking really quickly. Especially when I'm new to an area, so I'm being kind of really cautious and maybe taking a lot of swings to defeat enemies when I haven't learned their patterns yet and stuff like that. And given that I have no backup weapon, it's a really, really bad thing if I end up with my equipment breaking. So I'm just gonna leave that on. Oh yeah, I should mention where I am, by the way. So you access the new DLC area by going to the Iron Keep, and you go to the Primal Bonfire, which is after the... I don't remember his name, the big lava boss dude at the end of the level. Was that the Iron King? I think that was the Iron King. Anyway, yeah, go down to the Primal Bonfire. Come down here, and what you find here looks very much like the last thing that I used to access the last piece of DLC. It's kind of serpent-y little altar thing, although the serpents seem to be missing their heads, which is a little bit weird. Let's see if I can read these. Yeah. Forbidden is the path to the Ancient King's Domain. With water dry and path amiss, woeful temptation is dismissed. In the tower of the old Iron King resides a child of dark. Trespassers will face adversity befitting a monarch. A nice little bit of poetry. It rhymes. What do these notes say? Let me guess, something lewd. Hurrah for hint. Hint. This is a hint? With water dry and pathy mist, woeful temptation is dismissed. The hell is that a hint about? Be wary of quagmire, think carefully. Giggity. Here we go. So if you haven't guessed, given that we access this place from the Iron Keep, and it's called the Crown of the Iron King, or whatever the hell it's called? Sunken Crown of the... I'm confusing the name already. Anyway, given that, it's of course set in a lava area, which would be quite fun. I'm looking forward to having all of my flesh melted. Key required ahead. Gorgeous view ahead. Ah, that's probably the key I got as I logged in. Ooh, look at that door. Even the door is ridiculously detailed and beautiful. Look at that thing. You think all those little holes up there and that big wheel thing are like storage compartments? Oh, maybe some squirrels have like... or birds have stored some nuts in there. Could go for a snack right now. Gorgeous view ahead. Well, must be above me, because this is not a gorgeous view. Anyway, before I go there, let's see what's off to the sides. Oh yeah, these things. They're in the last DLC area too. The sign written here is being channeled from somewhere far away. I have no idea what that means. Probably the same thing on the other side, right? Now, I believe these are the areas where you can summon people that don't own the DLC, because apparently there's some sort of stuff. There's some sort of a thing where you can summon people that don't have the DLC and they can experience some of the content. I don't know, it's weird. Illusion? No. Triporcel? What? Try horse. What? That doesn't even. Congratulations, you finished the DLC. I'm gonna upvote that. Alright. I wish I could look up more, but I'm pretty sure I'm going really, 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 really high up. Oh, not that high. Hold on, what's this thing? Visions of gorgeous view. Why do I feel like I'm gonna face a boss already? It's extremely unlikely, because there's no freaking bonfire here. There's no way. Here we go. Ho 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 boy! Gorgeous view, indeed. Holy crap, let's walk up to the edge. Holy shit, that is... My god, that is ridiculously beautiful. Whoa. Let me get a slow rotate. There we go. Beautiful. You know, normally I don't like depth of field effects. Especially when they make areas blurry where you're actually looking. You know, so they're not focusing like your eyes actually would. But in this case, the background being all blurry, I don't know, it actually really works. It gives everything a sense of scale, you know? Like, it's so far away it's blurry, like I can't even imagine how far of a distance it is to the ground. It really helps separate the objects that are closer to me from the ones far away, which, in this case, actually works. That sky. Oh my god. Beautiful. You know, I think this might be where... If I didn't read this description wrong, I think this might be where the iron was produced. The reason I say that is because the description for the key... That's the key I got for the DLC, Heavy Iron Key. Says, past the altar deep within the Iron Keep and through a door is the tower that the old Iron King used to produce iron. Okay, so I'm in a tower and I just went up in it. So I'm pretty sure this is the tower, or the towers. The unearthly weight of this chunk of iron is a reminder of the Iron King's own immeasurable strength. And it does look like a forge over there. Billowing out flames or something. So, this is ash, not snow, right? Yeah, that's gotta be ash. Yeah, it's definitely ash. I think? Yeah, it's ash. There's no way it's snow. That wouldn't make any sense. But then again, there's really not that much about this game that does make sense. So, it wouldn't actually surprise me. Am I gonna take that thing's soul? What is that? What is that thing? I feel like it's gonna come to life when I take out its soul. And I wonder if it alone defeated all of these people here. Oh. Smelter wedge. Oh, I get to crawl across that chain? Oh, that is so cool. Alright, hold on. Let's see if I can find it in the bottomless abyss. It was an item, right? Let's see if I can find it without painstakingly going through everything. So I've got six of it, and it should look like a wedge or something. Oh, there we go. Destroys Ashen Idol. Forged in this land, destroys the Ashen Idol. The Ashen Idol is of great consequence to Nadalia, who, having renounced her flesh, entrusts her very being to it. Entrusts her being to the Ashen Idol. I don't understand. Destroys the Ashen Idol. Not Ashen Idols. The Ashen Idol. There's only one of them. So why do I have six of these? I guess we'll find out. Recklessness? So many people died here. I wonder what they died from. Falling? Just had to get a closer look, huh? Actually, this looks like there's items below me. Yeah, there's even an enemy down there. Yeah, at some point I'm gonna be down there. I think somebody entrusted their cat ring a little bit too much in preventing falling damage. Hell, I could probably jump down there if I wanted to, actually. But let's just go the normal way. Broom Tower. There's the first Bonnie. Throne Floor. Can I store items here? Oh, I can. Alright, let's store those damn trousers. Leggings, whatever. Okay, I feel better. Help me. Wish I could. Well, I guess I could just fall down there and start going down if I wanted to. I wanna know how to get to the other side of this gear, though, because there's an item there. Is there a way on top of that gear? Because if I could get on that gear, I could walk around. I mean, I can't make that jump, can I? Actually, you know what? I probably could. Hold on, let me check my jump distance. Maybe. No. Oh good, there's a way up. Oh shit. Hi. Hello? Hello? I can't target it. Is that an Ashen Idol? Be gone, demon! Is it gonna explode? Okay. Well, it did kind of explode, but not violently. Soul of Nadalia, Bride of... what? Was it a boss? Okay, defeated my first boss, I'm good. DLC's over. Yeah, see? Boss? I was confused too. I think I might have just done something horrible. That's probably gonna come back to bite me in the ass. I don't know. She's trying to burn me. What are you supposed to do with people that try to burn you? Of course you stab them with a smelter wedge. Oh shit. Whew. Dexterity ring. Well, that looks like a boss down there. Alright, check out this ring. Yeah, let's go through the inventory. I guess. Increases dexterity? Well, duh. The king's power allowed him to mold iron freely, as if he held sway over the forces of life and creation. Right. How much does it increase my dexterity? Not that it really matters. Because I don't need more, but let's go ahead and put it on anyway. Let's see, does it reflect that here? I believe it does, actually. It's weird that it doesn't have, like, a blue, you know, like, in parentheses, blue color or whatever, plus 5 or something, to actually tell me that it's not my base stat, but I believe it was 15 and now it's 20, right? Just double-check that. Yeah, so it increases it by 5, which is actually quite a bit. But, once again, I don't need it. Looks like a throne. Take a look at that soul, too. I've got so many souls. Where are you? What? Did I miss it? Fuck it. Black hole of an inventory, goodbye. It's gone forever. There really needs to be a new item thing to show you what the hell you just picked up. There really, really needs to be. It's ridiculous. I can't believe they haven't added that. Yeah, I'm still pretty sure I can't make this. Ooh, you know what? I think I can. That was really close. I want whatever that item is. So I want as far close to the left as possible. Oh yes, I did it! Stay calm, keep moving. Baneful bird ring. What? Is somebody gonna come pluck me from the sky? Hello? Stay calm, keep moving. And I just picked up a bird ring. Okay. Oh, for the love of God. Reduces stamina loss when blocking with shield. Well, that is 100% useless for me. Because I don't use a shield. The Ring of Rame the Traitor. Rame was an agile swordsman who served King Vendrick, but after resigning from his post, he reconsidered his way of life and was born again as a stalwart warrior. Oh shit. Well, that didn't quite work. Let's just swap out this ring. Right. I think I need to go down there, don't I? Yeah, she's not coming back. Probably use a cat ring while I'm going down there. I hear voices. Very faint. Oh, hi. Not a good time to do that. I wanted to change my ring before fighting. Damn, you look badass, man. Do you really think you'd hit me from there? Can I stun him? Oh, I can. Really? I can stun him? That's gonna make this so easy. Whoops. Your fighting prowess is at odds with how badass you look. That was incredibly easy. Well, DLC is over. I beat it. Oh. I'm sorry. Alright, these voices are creeping me out. Is that the voices of the ashen people? Any secrets I could fall down onto? Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa. Nope. Oh, there's a lot of bloodstains here. Yeah, these are very easy enemies. I'm surprised. You know, I don't want to say my skills haven't degraded as much as I thought they have, but I think these might just be really easy enemies. I can't take this. Yes, you can! They're so easy! What are you talking about? Rouge water. Oh yeah, I think I've gotten that before. Oh, hi. That's her again, isn't it? Now I really want to know where that soul was. It was a soul, wasn't it? Maybe it was something else. Oh, it's the first fucking one! There it is. Bride of Ash, who renounced her flesh and wandered Broom Tower. When Nidalia came to this land, the king she sought was no longer there. Dispirited, she forsook her own soul and clung to the heirlooms of the old king. This is only a fragment of a soul, and cannot be used in this state. Oh. Okay, so yeah, it's just a very small part of it, so that explains why I have so many of these smelter wedges. Although it's strange that the name of it is Soul of Nidalia, when it should be Fragment of a Soul of Nidalia. It's a misleading name, even if it does say it in the description. This feels like the gigantic pit. Back from the starting area all over again. Oh, hi. What is that thing? It's a specter. No. No, I wanted you to read the note. Tracer, circling around. Blackweed bomb. Don't know if I've gotten that before. Yeah, I must have. Temporarily increases intelligence, okay. Whoa. Comes already in plus 7. Nice. And I can actually find it. Look at that. It's here. It's amazing. Oh, that thing's so cute. Look at it. It's like my halberd, except it does way less damage. It's so cute. It thinks it's a real weapon. Nothing can match Halby. Extended slashing reach when swung broadly, but beware, these attacks make the wielder very vulnerable. Yeah, what does it require, as far as stats go? Does it not say? They both have the same poise. It weighs a little bit less. I think it says if you go to equip it, right? Isn't that where it says? Yeah. Okay, so... yeah, it actually has less requirements than my halberd. Surprisingly. See what this thing looks like. Okay, it's very, very, very slightly longer. Looks like the blade itself is actually longer, though. So maybe it'd be easier to get a good hit. It's actually good as a backup weapon. I mean, it's not nearly as good as my halberd, but I can actually use it. Compared to this thing's 417, this thing does about 332 exactly. Yeah, it's actually a pretty good backup weapon. With the ashen knuckle ring thingamajig, though, I probably don't need it. Be really surprised if my equipment breaks. Prism stone. Whoops, didn't mean to press that. Have I gotten that before? Oh my god. Fuck my inventory. Prism, prism. Prism. It's not a damn soul. Oh, it's the shitty things that just make light. Yay! Sparklies! Ooh, they tickle. No, read the note! You're closer to the note than the freaking ladder! Just ahead. Okay. Oh, yeah, here. Oh! Right, it's a real chest amongst a bunch of fake chests, I guess. Is it a trap? Probably not. Who cares? If a monster wants to eat my face, it can eat my face. Cool. A slab that I can use on nothing because I have nothing to upgrade. Except things that I don't use. Hi. Alright. I'm gonna have to take on the enemies before stabbing her with the wedge. Whoa, she seems... or I mean, this enemy seems like it's... ashen. It seems stronger. Alright. We got problems. The biggest problem being that I'm dead. The other one being that I'm thirsty. Ah. Well, there goes my two rings. Time to get them repaired. Well, it's nice to see the enemies get harder. I feel like they're just being kind of, like, imbued with power by Nadalia, because her ashen idol is near them. You know, something that I've almost never used is my coins. My, lucky coins. Yeah, temporarily boosts luck, which I believe gives you better drops. Oh, ran out of stamina. Okay. In fact, maybe I should stab her first. That might get rid of their enhancement. Can I do that? Can I be interrupted while I'm stabbing her? Alright, let's get them over here. Oh, I can't even do it anymore, can I? Oh, wait, yes I can. I just need to do it from this side. Alright, come on. Oh, shit, I just got another one. Fuck me. Quickly! Okay, yeah. I think it worked. Oh, if I could do an AoE amongst them. Kinda worked. Please don't backstab me. Drinking that potion did pretty much nothing because I lost all the health. Oh no. Oh, son of a bitch. Alright, well, at least I took her out, so. Next time I go there, I believe she will not come back. No, that wouldn't make any sense because the last one didn't. Plus, I only have a limited amount of wedges, so. Yeah, she's not coming back. I almost just took a shortcut. And then I realized that's stupid. Couldn't avoid that one. You know, I could just go down there. No, let's keep going this way. Alright, this should be way easier. Not a good place to be. Okay, we're fine. Another soul, which is not actually a soul, it's a soul fragment. Yeah, let's go this way. Spell? Doesn't matter, don't use spells. Looking for secret chambers. See if I can get a backstab in. I feel like some of these bars might break when I walk over them. Nowhere to jump to from here. Although, I suppose with a cat ring, I could maybe survive getting down there. Maybe. Oh, look at that aggressive LOD. Look at that door back there in the pillar. Boom. Wait, what does this say? Here, by the way, below. What, are you saying I can break it or something? Yep. Okay. Beautiful. Treasure. I don't see any treasure. I just see ashen people. Is it hidden inside the ashen people? Oh. Man, now we need to ruin all their bodies. I feel bad about that. A couple mundane stones. Hi, I heard you. Ooh! Keep me on my toes there, I like it. Let's not discuss those textures. Let's just pretend that didn't happen. Try range battle or pyromancy? No. Whoa. A health bar just popped up down there. Looks like it was getting hurt by something. What the fuck? What the fuck? Hi. Are those explosive barrels? Those things are creepy as hell! They are explosive. And these are too. Do they explode if you roll through them? I suppose I shouldn't try. Black firebomb. I'm assuming that's a throwable. Yeah, there it is. Hi, horsey. Looks like I can be here safely, right? Yeah. Alright, well, I gotta keep in mind, I still have an unexplored area. Back towards the beginning in that huge shaft where I could fall down and fight those spectral things. You're almost dead already. You kept getting burned! That didn't work. Holy shit, that is some range! Oh, shit. Whoops. Yeah, they have a really long sword and a huge bow. Bug ahead, try dash. Why'd you put that on the wall? Hi. Get out of the way! They're gonna burn! Oh, they're gonna blow.
Go closer to the fire, yes! Yes! Closer!
I wonder if they're the miners. You can see there's buckets of, well, boxes of ore here. Or ingots or whatever. I hear somebody scrambling about down here. Hi. You can't even see me, can you? There you go. Projectiles. Okay. Whoops. I see. Oh no, I destroyed it! Please don't trap me in here. Shit. Yeah, wearing this ash knuckle ring is so worth it. I know by this point my weapon would be, like, almost broken. Rubbish. It's okay. It was just a wooden chest. There probably is nothing special in it. Bonfire ahead on the right. Okay. Bonnie! Am I gonna get burned? These horses are looking at me. Hi. 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 Hey, it looks just like me. We're in the same armor. Although with a dinner plate for a shield. Okay, well, since I'm here, why don't we go back here and look at that area that I didn't explore? Might lead to the same area for all I know, but I want to check it out. Large soul. Oh yeah, double kill. Triple kill. Holy shit. See what's down here. Now there's a spectral thingamajig. Holy shit, that range! Okay, that is not a backwards dodge, that's a sideways dodge. can take a lot of damage. Alright. Thankfully, I can stun him. Yeah, that thing has ridiculous range. Alright, that's just down there, which I've already been to. Ah, okay. Victory! Cool. I wonder if these DLCs have any shard flasks. Flask shards. Or if you're stuck with however many you had before. Alright, where to go from here? I came from up there. Right? Yeah. Let's get rid of those enemies. There we go. Don't want them following me. So, this way goes where? Ooh. Is that a boss? No, okay. Oh yeah, I remember seeing the fog door. From up above. The lift needs to move. Was that water? Or oil. I think it's water. Does it matter? The spectral things do have, like, fire swords, so if it is oil, that would matter. Because I'd probably go up like dry tinder. What makes this thing go up? There's no lever. There's a ladder there. Alright, so that just generally goes deeper down, so where does the other way go? Let me guess. Locked door. Does not open from this side. Okay. Hi. Hold on. Excuse me a second. Oh. Interesting. That's really cool. Look at that. Alright, how do I get in there? Have to open it from the other side. Where leads in there? It's gotta be a staircase or something. Alright, well, probably come back to that later. I think I'm actually gonna end this here. Yeah, just found a new bonfire. Scouted out the area, I now know where to go. There's only one direction to go at the moment. That's down here. Yeah, pretty good place to end it, because otherwise I'm just going to want to keep going until I find the next bonfire, which could take a long time. So, yeah, this DLC is really cool so far, which is not surprising, because the last one was very cool. You know, interesting new environment, interesting new enemies, new items, things of that sort. The whole multiple souls thing, like the fragments of, what was her name? Sort of an N, Nadia. Nadalia, that's it. Yeah, the whole smelter wedge thing where there's like fragments of her all over the place, and if you leave them up, they can hurt you in some way, either by, like, the first one just made fire appear, or the second one buffed up the enemies around her. Kind of take out these different shades of hers, if you can call them that. Getting little bits of her soul along the way. It's a very interesting mechanic. Yeah, cool environments, interesting enemies. And there's something else I was going to say, but I don't remember what it was. Oh, yes! This is going a hell of a lot smoother than the last DLC went. Man, when I first started that last DLC, The Crown of the Sunken King, I felt really out of practice. I just did so bad at the beginning. The enemies were so ridiculously hard to me. I think a big reason for that is because they tended to be enemies that couldn't really be stunned by my attacks, which made it extremely difficult. But these enemies so far do actually seem stunnable, which is a welcome relief. That makes all the difference, because I don't have a shield. So if I can't stun them, the most I could do is try to take advantage of their hopefully slow attacks to get, you know, one or two attacks in and then dodge away, but that is quite difficult sometimes. So this is going much smoother than the last one. Which is good, I think. As long as the DLC doesn't end up being too easy. Hopefully not. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.